This is day three. Today I'm going to show you how to install this rubber landing path here that is used to hold in place the rudder blade while you don't want to use it when transporting also the kayak. This is the best way to keep it there safe. I found it in a Walmart store, and basically, you know, comes with two of those rubber pieces, and it's basically very handy in this situation. What I'm going to do is I'm using a piece of strap that I cut and burn the edge of it, also the end of a bungee cord that I'm going to put this way, and it will be down here once I drill a hole through the rubber piece, and it will then have this end hook at the, of the bungee here. So once the blade is in place, this will hold it just like that. This rubber bungee has this end that I already pre-cut, and you can just easily attach to it just by putting the end, inserting the end to the bungee as far as you can, trying to make a rest like that, and then this sleeve, plastic sleeve, just goes in and keep it right there, safe in place. So this is how it looks once it's all in, and then it has the bungee effect and makes it a very useful piece. I'm also going to show you, as I said yesterday, how to crimp the wire and also to add this detail that is basically a heat shrink tubing that will also cover, you know, the ferrules that are holding in place this wire. This is the stainless steel wire that is used to steer the rudder. So in order to install this rubber pad here, I would need to drill a hole, and on the other side, on the inside, we'll have this lock nut. In order to reach that lock nut there, I will need to have some assistance here from one of my sons, because I mean, this space from the cockpit to that location is about 3 feet, and there is no hatch here to help me reach with my arm. So I will need to also remove the styrofoam that is kept in place with this screw. Removing the screw that holds the styrofoam. Removing the styrofoam. Drill the hole. So heat up the tip of a nail, as we want to make a hole to that strap that is going to be between the rubber pad and the kayak. And once you have this enough hot, just go and drill, punch a hole that will provide a very clean hole there, about in the middle of it. So this bolt will be able to pass right there and then through the kayak. Well, with the help of a little guy, can you move your foot? Okay. The little guy is holding the nut on the other side. Really, these little guys are really handy. So I'm going to tighten up this bolt here. Are you there?
Yeah.
Okay. So with this wonderful helper, we managed to install this rubber land for the rotor blade. I already connect one of the wires to the rotor control track here, so and it consists of the stainless steel bolt, then a nut washer, then comes the wire, another washer, and then the lock nut. And I didn't tighten it, so it's flush with the end of the screw there, so it freely moves. This track then goes in the piece that is on the hole, and then you see that this can move in order to operate the rotor from here. I already passed one of the wires through the tubing till here, and it's still uncut. And I'm going to show you how to pass the other one. So I'm inserting the wire through the tubing till it reaches the end at the stern here. And it's not accident, because the cable has some wires there. So what you are going to do is just twist the cable several times until the cable at the end will make it way through it. So you keep doing this and you will see that the cable is here. You can pull it using some long nose pliers, and there you go. So we will then attach this to the track that has already the bolt with the washers and lock nut. I am also checking that these pedals are about the same distance both, so I put some masking tape there to fix them, because I'm going to pull these cables just a little on the back end of the or the stern, and then I will proceed to make to the crimping here on both sides, and I'm showing you how to do that in a moment. For this connection here at the rudder, we're going to be using 3/16 by 3/4 of an inch stainless steel bolt with the lock nut and two washers. So first, what we need to do is put the bolt at the end, grab the cable wire, bend it there just enough to have a length, so you don't need to pull that too much from the kayak. Then using a cutter, just cut about 2 inches of the wire, so you know that you're not going to use more than that. And then now we're going to use ferrules. These are ferrules that we're going to crimp to hold this in place. You try to bend the wire using the bolt there, because you don't want to have a sharp bend there. You want to have a smooth a bend, so the wire is not going to try to break there. Also, we're going to be using some shrink tubing that's available in any hardware store to protect that connection or the area with the crimp.